Hey everybody, welcome back to Shorty Mac TV. Thank y'all for tuning in. Please hit the notification bell so you're alert each time I upload a new video. Like, share, subscribe, comment below, all those great YouTube things. And thanks again for tuning in. So for today's topic, what I want to talk about is fear and how fear basically gets in the way of us doing anything and stop us from doing anything. For example, with the climate that we're in right now, with everything going on, the innocent killings of black men that's happening at the arms of police officers right now, that's implanting a fear in all of our people of the police. Right now, everybody is scared of the police because they think every encounter with the police is going to result in them losing their life, which I understand because it's so much going on, and that is the case. It also plants a fear in our brain, like with everything going on, it stops us from being able to retaliate or defend ourselves. Pretty much what I'm saying is people are scared and fearful of losing their life, but at the same time they're also scared to fight for their lives. Right now it's a lot of people that's upset. Everybody want to retaliate some type of way, but they're also scared to lose their life and furthermore fight for their life. My thing is, there's power in numbers. If we can come together and just let all the BS that's going on, because right now it's a divide between black people, and you know, in between that there's further divide between men and women, and right now it's not the time for us to further divide ourselves with, you know, what's going on. We need to let all the BS go, come together and fight literally fight for our lives and our freedom, because all the other stuff is not doing anything. So we have to release that fear of dying, because we already know that we're gonna die. Why not go out fighting for something that you strongly believe in, you know? And it's just like that fear has been planted into our people for decades. Like, we have this strong fear of a dying by the hands of police officers, and I understand because they show it time after time on media, and I think that's part of the point too. Like, some of these stories I do know is real, and it did happen, but some of the stories I feel like are fabricated, or it's probably old stories that's resurfacing just to get a reaction out of us, because again, we're in a time that's like election time, so they're gonna do every and anything that they can to try to steal our votes and all this type of stuff. To me, all of this that's going on, they're benefiting off of it politically, and that's just the way I see. So we need to remove that fear from our hearts and just fight for our lives. Like, it's no way that we should just be bogged down by fear and not be able to defend ourselves and just rely on praying. Now, I'm not a Christian, and I don't consider myself religious, but I do know somewhere in the Bible it say faith without works is dead. So how can we just pray and just assume that everything is gonna be okay? We have to put in some work. Yes, it's okay to pray, but we also gotta do something to back those prayers up, show some work and put it in there. You know, faith without works is dead. So I say prayer without works is dead as well. So we just gotta remove that fear out of our hearts and just stand up and for what's right. And if we have to, if we lose our life in the meantime, that's just how it's gotta be. I'm sorry. I strongly believe in fighting for something that you strongly believe in, you know, especially for us, because freedom. We just we just want to be treated fair, honestly. Like, we ain't asking for anything that, what we're asking for is not hard. Like, we just asking to be treated fair. Like, just leave us alone, you know? And that's it. And so because we can't get that, I feel like we just gonna have to go and demand it and show them, y'all go stop messing with us. And if not, this is what's gonna happen. So we need to come together and remove that fear of dying and just rise up for our community. And another thing that fear does, it stops us from doing basically everything. And I'm laughing because, like, I'm trying to get my words out. I have, like, my thoughts are just floating everywhere, and I'm trying to communicate this well so that y'all can understand. But another thing that fear has done is stop us from having a voice. Like, we're so scared of what this person is going to think of us. We're scared of what, you know, what people are going to think of us for saying something, and you know, scared of having a voice, pretty much. And that goes to, like, all of these like entertainers and stuff like that. They haven't spoke out on a lot of things that's going on because they scared of losing. Y'all see what's going on with people that speak up, and then when they get it cancel culture and all that. So they're scared to speak up on certain events because they scared they're gonna lose supporters, they're gonna lose deals for companies, because companies gonna be like, oh nah, we gotta drop out. They're scared of just cancel culture. They scared of offending people. And I just wish people would just stop being scared. And I hate the politically correct culture, or if that's what it's called. And that stop people from having a, it stops people from having a opinion on stuff, because you got to be so politically correct. People can't even say anything this more. You can't. These days, I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry if I'm rambling. I'm all over the place. It's hard. Like, I'm trying to articulate my thoughts. But it's hard to have a voice now because cancel culture is so strong, and they ready to cancel you for any little thing. If you don't agree with someone, they ready to cancel you. If you don't agree with the majority of how other people think, they ready to stop supporting you. Are they... they're ready to pull out of these deals that you had going on with these companies. And it's just terrible. I hate it. Like, it just comes a time where all of that has to stop. We have to not be so fearful of what other people think about us and have our own voice. And I do salute some of the people that have been like, you know what, if I lose my job for saying this, so be it. When they speaking on, you know, the events that's going on right now, the, you know, the killings of our black men, some people are not afraid to speak up now. They like, look, I got a voice and I have an opinion, and this is how I feel. And if I lose my job, or if I lose supporters in the midst of me, you know, doing that, then so be it. And I wish everybody had that mindset, but we so scared of what other people gonna think. And I just want people to remove that fear. Like, man, just I'm sorry, y'all. It's hard for me to articulate. I just can't understand why people are so afraid to speak out. And, you know, I get it, because, you know, cancel culture and all this type of stuff. But it's time for all that fear to just go. It's just time. So I think that's all I have to say about fear. And to me, closing out, fear to me is just a thought. And it's something that's in your head. Oh, I can't do something because this and this can happen. Are you so focused on what can go wrong, but nobody ever focused on what can go right? So to me, fear is just a mindset thing. It's something that's implanted in your mind. You think you can't do certain things, but you can. You can do anything that you want. You're the creator over your life, and you have the power to create and do anything over your life. So I want everybody to remove that fear out of your lives and just live your life fear free. That's how I am right now. I don't really know what fear is. I know what fear is. What I'm doing is I'm facing my fear, I'm embracing it, I'm sitting with it, and I'm figuring out a way to overcome that fear. That's what I'm doing. So I encourage everybody to do that as well. Figure out why you have this fear of, you know, what's going on, and just sit with it. It's okay. Sit with it and then find out a way to overcome it. And that's my... And that's all I have to say on fear. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and comment below. Subscribe, hit the notification bell, all those great YouTube things. And see y'all on next video.